We integrate fish and poultry. When we have excess litter, we are putting it in the fish to fertilize the pond.
So what do we have here?
We have black soldier fly, which is a source of our protein and fat. The black soldier fly has a very long life cycle, but we try to break it into different value chain nodes.
Okay.
Here as a farm, we supply eggs. Our main business is raising eggs for black soldier fly.
Okay.
These eggs are sold to our youth.
Mm.
Then our youth are able to have the eggs hatch into larvae, and they raise this larvae to different stages.
Mm.
And at maybe so. These are now the black soldier flies.
Okay, the mature ones.
The mature ones that are now laying eggs.
They're laying here?
Yes, they are laying between the wooden blocks.
Hey.
Each day we come and scrape off the eggs they have laid. So we take those eggs into another medium.
How many tons do you harvest?
Tons. It's kilos.
Kilos.
Tons is a big responsibility, okay, my friend.
So these are eggs?
So these are eggs that we have gotten from that site. We put them in another media. You can't see them now.
Are they alive?
Yes, eggs are alive, definitely. Now, these eggs will now hatch into... Not yet hatched.
They are not.
Let me get
hatched
for you the ones that have hatched here. It is still warm. Okay, the person in charge is not here. But I can try to get to the different. This is still warm. They are also not hatched. But I'm lucky I have the ones that have hatched just here. You can, I don't know if you can come closer. No, I want you to come closer.
Okay. Maybe they can zoom in the camera.
No, let me first remove this one. It is a bit warm, but it's okay. So these ones have hatched now. I don't know if you see those little beautiful larva.
Wow.
Now.
Are they feeding on something there?
Yes, they are feeding. This is what we would call the chicken litter. So they are feeding on chicken litter. But we can also mix in with other, maybe food residues. Yes.
Wow.
So this is a bigger size.
Yeah, they are bigger.
This is bigger.
Is that still the larvae?
You see the larvae. The larvae has, we call them 5 instars, different stages of growth. So once it is like on the 4th instar, we can now harvest it to be able to produce the larvae for food.
For food?
Yes, because it's the larvae that we feed on.
Yeah, on the chicken.
On the chicken, so we mix. We chicken litter, then we mix. Now
these are leftovers.
These are leftovers, but you also mix with chicken litter. Yeah. These are still young also. They are more or less like the other ones we've just seen. Same aging. Yes. But you will find those that have turned.
Yes. How about these ones?
These ones is like the last stage. I wanted to show you the ones that are changing color.
Okay.
You see these ones?
Yeah.
They are becoming darker and becoming bigger. So this one is now trying to turn into pupa.
Okay.
It becomes, it's called pupa. They are trying to put this hard skin, and they won't eat in the pupa stage. They will not eat.
They will not eat?
They will not be eating because they are just, it's as good as something dead. Okay?
Okay.
So now, this may not be the best pupa stage, but normally the pupa stage you'll find that it looks like a dead.
But it's still alive.
No, this particular one is not there. It has already gone out. but it's dead. Mm-hmm. And it's the one that is going to hatch to give you the fly. Mm-hmm. Then the fly starts laying eggs. Once it has finished its laying cycle, it dies.
Okay.
Yes.
I heard that people are making cakes out of black.
Yes, soil. The oil.
The oil, eh?
Yes.
Okay.
So we dry it and we make. So this is the larva that was picked at that stage. Mm-hmm. Now it is dry. Wow. Now when it is dry, you can mill it to be able to mix it in the normal feed.
Or you can give them like this.
You can give them like this, but also the other ones that are still fresh, you can also feed on them directly.
Wow.
But this will reduce, remember this is your waste. Mm. So it will reduce your cost and you bought the litter anyway. So it's okay. But then you have another product called, another product that we call frass. This is like the leftovers of the
like
process.
Soil.
It's like soil. Mm. Or tea. Some people say it looks like tea leaves. Mm-hmm. So this is now the one we use for fertilizing the soil that is growing our soybean, that's growing our maize. Wow. So you are just rotating within the cycle of your poultry.
That's quite
So this is also a business of its own, but connected to poultry. Mm. Yes.
And it's an alternative to these high costs of feeds.
Like you can replace your fish needs with this, and also reduce your soybean needs. Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
Some of these plants are not here as a decoration. Yeah, they have antioxidants.
I was telling my family members that when I went to Good Farm, I found that they don't have flowers.
No, these are flowers.
They are flowers, but they use valuable flowers.
We use them for mixing in the feeds of the animals. Yeah, so each plant has a use in supporting the birds. Yeah, this is a chive. Chive is in the same family as the onions.
Yeah, I thought they were spring onions.
No. The spring onions are these ones. See, they are lighter. The color is lighter.
Yeah.
But it's in the same family. If you smell on the chive, it smells like onion and garlic together.
True.
And it's a very important medicine for your birds. You can mix it in the feeds. You don't give too much, but it's just an antioxidant to cleanse your buds. Then when you look at the far end, it's a little far, we have moringa, the one which has the long pods. We also use leaves as multivitamins. In our rural places where our youth come from, they may not have the capacity to afford the commercial multivitamins, but they can grow that tree of moringa. They can grow coriandra, which is next, and then they use the leaves for feeding.
Mm-hmm.
Again,
what's over here?
Here, this is fish. We integrate fish and poultry. When we have excess litter, we are putting it in the fish to fertilize the pond.
That's impressive.
It's
so
zero
catfish?
Yes, we are into catfish.
Okay.
So a pawpaw is very important in our value chain as well. We mainly use the seeds of the pawpaw for deworming. It's our main dewormer. You so dry them, you can crush them and put it in the feed. We actually pelletize them, and when the animals eat them, the worms. Because you cannot guarantee a mobile animal, you can't guarantee what it's eating. But actually, it's also a dewormer for human beings.
Is it?
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah. So you can eat your nakati, but if you fail to get market, still your animal can consume your nakati. Here we pack seeds. We sell seeds of nakati. We actually also sell seeds of pawpaws as well. This is a pepper.
Yeah, I can see it's green pepper.
Yes. And it's not green pepper, it's pepper as in chili.
Oh, chili!
Yeah, which is a very important thing in our concoctions which we make. The concoctions for especially coccidiosis, we put in pepper as well.
Mm.
But again, the one eating chicken can as well consume the pepper.
Wow. Mm. Where did you get this idea of...
No, I think the idea has come from... I do farm tourism. If I go to any country, or my schedule always put visiting a farm. So it's like an amalgamation of different ideas. Here we have our transport section. We also train youth who transport our animals.
Is it important?
Very, very important. How do you transport a chicken to reach when it's still healthy? How do you transport it when it's already dressed? And how do you speak for it? Because the customer interfaces with the transporter, not the farmer. For you might know my chicken is this and this, my chicken fed on this and this, but the person delivering it doesn't have that information. So the customer asks, which chicken is this? Ah, I don't know. And that could be the reason the customer doesn't buy. So you have to train them and tell them, you are selling this chicken, it has grown like this, it fed like that.
I actually had a story that some supermarket almost rejected, I don't remember the company, because they were supposed to transport the chicken in a fridge and then they brought it in a different carrier.
Yes.
I had. So no. Is that so serious?
No, that is serious because you can end up selling, poisoning your customers.